Enzo Plonka.
I don't think it was a thing.
I'll be a hymn book. We'd now like to play our second piece, which is called Mary's Boy Child, and it will feature our principal choir player, Matthew Croft, and euphonic players at the back, Paul and Rachel. So, Mary's Boy Child.
Thank you. We're delighted to welcome yet again the Rolls-Royce Ladies Choir and also Newmount Brass. We're delighted especially to have Newmount Brass with us, as they have now taken the name of this church and they use it as part of their main rehearsal base. And we're just so glad that you're able again to come and give us a concert. I hope that you all have a programme, as there is some audience participation required. You will see from the programme that there are some audience carols. The words are in here, should you need them. They also appear on the wall, because it's all part of the modern technology. There will be refreshments served in the interval, in the court, so if you'd like to collect a cup of coffee or a cup of tea and mince pie or jam tart, you can either eat it out there or bring it back in here and eat it. Toilets, should you need them during the concert, are through the open door, through the walkway and turn right. And should we need to evacuate the building during the course of the concert, then the fire exits are here and here and out through the main door, and the fire assembly point is out on the grass at the front. I think that's about all. Though if you've got a mobile phone, please turn it off or turn it so that we can appreciate the band and the choir without the added extra percussion. Thank you to Alan and to Christine, and I'll hand over to you.
Well, we're always pleased to be back here. Now it's our home base, obviously, but in previous years. We also are always delighted to play and sing with the Ladies Choir and do this joint concert. And it's a pleasure to have you with us again tonight, ladies. I'm Christine. Big applause, please, for Rolls-Royce Ladies Choir.
to Leslie.
Good luck, Leslie. I love talking on the microphone.
I don't think I need this because I've got quite a loud voice,
actually. Ladies and gentlemen, our next song, our next carol, is one that you'll be very familiar with. But this version varies to the one that I was always used to, in that in this one, there's no rising of the sun, there's no running of the deer, there's no playing of the merry organ, and if you, most worryingly of all, there's no sweet singing of the choir. However, we do have the holly in the ivy.
Thank you.
just while the getting the next piece of music sorted out, last Wednesday we was had to go to a council meeting, Derby City Council meeting, and we put in for a grant, because obviously when you start a band you want a lot of money, and if instruments alone, I would think for this band would cost about £40,000, easy. But all but about four players have got their own instruments, so we was lucky. We went to the council, we put a good case forward, and they allocated us a few thousand pounds, which we are delighted with. The first thing we had to buy was a new set of music stands, which we've now got, and a case to carry them in, and we're having uniform jackets and banners to go on the stands. They will be with us hopefully by about end of February. So that was one good piece of news. The other thing is we're a very much a happy family band here. I won't introduce all the families what's in this year because I've done it before. Well, I see one grandma shaking her head and saying, please do it. But no, we've got a lot of brothers and mothers and with children in the band, and we just treat it as a good, happy family band. If you know anybody who wants to come along to join us, we will be pleased to see them on a Wednesday evening, 7:15 in the room at the back. Or if you want to get in contact, there's the band manager sitting here on my left. He will put you right and tell you where to go if you would like to come. Right, our next piece is called Walking in the Air from the Snowman.
Thank you.
once again, it is Christine and the ladies' choir.
Thou must leave thy lowly dread.
Thank you. us for you. Imagine, if you will, the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The children at last have gone to bed, and despite what they want, their eyes are closed, and they're in dreamland, so they don't hear the jingle of distant bells, and they don't see a shadow across the moon. St. Nicholas is on his way. If you listen carefully while we're singing this, not that I'm suggesting that you don't anyway, in the chorus you can hear the rhythmic beat of the reindeer's hooves, and you can also hear the sleigh winding through the air. We hope!
Bye.
We've got to follow that. It was brilliant. I think the ladies' choir are getting better each year. They really performed well tonight, as they have done other years, but excellent. Thank you. Now look here, boys and girls, I'm in a bit of a mess. You can see five people's gone out. And they've gone a bit of a strike. They've said they don't want to play anymore. And I've got a new piece. We've only played it once before. It's called Hawaiian Samba. Shall we play it, or can we manage without them? Can we manage without them?
Yeah.
Right, we'll manage without them. Right. They need to come back, no, they. Well, shepherds watch their flocks by night. Afterwards, there will be a short interval, and cups of tea will be served in the foyer. Is that right, Ruth? Okay. Right, while shepherds watch.